शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तब जय गाथा जन जन मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे।
On behalf of Mrs. Meena Das Narayan, publisher and editor-in-chief of Gulf Connoisseur, and Mr. Narayan Nedungadi, managing director of 21st Century Publishing House, we welcome you to the Hebron Connoisseur Awards Night 2014. This year, as Gulf Connoisseur celebrates its 11th anniversary, we celebrate some very exceptional people who have excelled in their fields, contributed immensely to society and brought about positive change. They have become icons for the younger generation. Every year, we celebrate the Gulf Connoisseur Awards Night in Dubai. This year, we decided to host it in the beautiful garden city of Bangalore with the support of Hebron Properties. Today, we honor the voices that deserve accolades for many a time fighting alone to bring justice, progress, innovation and change in their respective fields. These individuals are people who have gone beyond their realm of specialization to achieve their mission. Gulf Connoisseur made a list of such dynamic individuals in different fields like politics, science, medicine, music, art, sports, movies and IT, and sent it to their readers. The list was further honed by a panel of three judges, connoisseurs in their own field, to arrive at the final result. The panel consists of Deepa Subramaniam, a leading art curator and businesswoman, Veena Murthy, a renowned danseuse, and Meena Das Narayan, writer, poet, artist, and movie maker. A special thanks goes to them. Now, we request His Excellency Shri Vajubhai Wala, Honorable Governor of Karnataka, to kindly light the lamp. We would like Shri B.S. Yediyurappa, former Chief Minister of Karnataka, Mrs. Meena Das Narayan, Mr. Satish Koshi, Managing Director of Hebron Properties, Mr. Priyanand, CEO of Hebron Properties, and Mr. Narayan Nedungadi to kindly join him on stage. Which was founded in 2003 by Mrs. Meena Das Narayan, is one of the leading luxury magazines in the UAE. During this period, it has won 3 gold awards from the Dubai International Print Awards, organized by Dubai Chamber of Commerce. The magazine has set standards in quality. We will now show you a short clipping of the evolution of Gulf Connoisseur.
No. Let's go straight to number one. Fingers through my hair. Touch me. Let's go straight to number one.
Oh, must really say that I'm so pleased to have worked so closely with Mina and Ned over the last 7 years. I really remember the first edition of Golf Connoisseur when we got involved, and year after year, really, it was an incredible pleasure to work with both of them on developing Golf Connoisseur. And really here with the second award ceremony taking place at the Armani Hotel, this is one more step in terms of collaboration. And when you look at Golf Connoisseur, the way it has evolved, and it's really targeting the same customers that we are targeting at Armani Dubai.
I now request Mr. Satish Koshi to present a bouquet to His Excellency Shri Vajubhai Wala, the Honorable Governor of Karnataka. Thank you, sir. I now request Mr. Narayan Nedumgadi to present a bouquet to Shri B.S. Yediyurappa, former Chief Minister of Karnataka. Thank you, sir. I would now request the publisher and editor-in-chief, Mrs. Meena Das Narayan, to welcome the guests.
Thank you, sir. His Excellency, the Governor of Karnataka, Shri B.S. Yediyurappa, eminent guests, ladies, gentlemen, it gives me immense pleasure to welcome you to our awards ceremony tonight. When we started Golf Connoisseur, we concentrated on producing a magazine that reflected quality in articles, layout and printing. And the hard work paid dividends in a country like UAE, where everything had to be the best. India today is on its path to excellence, with the Prime Minister Narendra Modi spelling out a very clear agenda to make India a superpower. Today, it is this synergy in excellence that we celebrate as we honour those who have been passionate, not only in their professions, but also in their dedication to society. 8 such people, some of whom have faced brickbats and yet survived, strive for excellence, people who have influenced others. This award is a recognition of your mission to take India forward, and it fills us with a sense of pride and patriotism. Thank you from all of us. A special thanks goes to Satish Koshi, Managing Director of Hebron Properties, and Priyanand, CEO of Hebron, who have partnered with us tonight. Finally, a special mention of Crystal House, our charity of choice, who are doing immense work to educate underprivileged children. We welcome you, ladies and gentlemen, to tonight's celebration as we celebrate some of the most exceptional people in India. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Meena. I now request His Excellency Shri Vajubhai Wala, the Honorable Governor of Karnataka, to launch our Indian edition cover by unveiling it. Hebron Properties is joining hands with Golf Connoisseur to publish the Indian edition of the luxury magazine. I request Mr. Satish Koshi and Mr. Priyanand to join us on stage. Thank you very much, esteemed guests. Golf Connoisseur would also like to request Mr. Satish Koshi to present a check of rupees 1.5 lakhs to Crystal House. We request Mr. Suresh Sood to come and receive the check. Crystal House has been doing immense work to educate underprivileged children, and they have a full-fledged school in Hepal. Ladies and gentlemen, I would also like to bring to your notice that the paintings you saw as you walked in are from a collection, Four Seasons in a Haveli, which depict the four seasons, spring, summer, monsoon and winter, from the eyes of a woman and her moods. These oil paintings are by Mrs. Meena Das Narayan. Now, we move on to the much awaited award ceremony. Our first award winner is a very eminent person who has changed the way Indians think. He has proved that the wealthy and powerful are not untouchables, and the corrupt can be punished. He is a man who does not mince words when it comes to stating facts and has always stood by his principles. It's these very qualities that has made him a darling of the people. Now, let us watch a video clipping about Dr. Subramanyam Swamy, the politician, economist and activist.
Dr. Subramanyam Swamy. Dr. Subramanyam Swamy is an Indian academician, politician, activist and economist. He was the founder of the Janata Party, which has recently merged with the Bharatiya Janata Party. Sri Subramanyam Swamy has previously served as a member of the Planning Commission and was also a cabinet minister. He completed his bachelor's degree in mathematics with honours from Hindu College, New Delhi. Next, he pursued his master's degree in statistics from the well-known Indian Statistical Institute, Calcutta. He earned a doctorate in economics from Harvard University in 1964. Subsequently, he served as professor of economics at Harvard University and at IIT New Delhi. On the home front, he has backed nuclear technology for scientific growth and social benefits. The present economic liberalization and reforms are partly a result of his far-sighted and sharp vision. He also played a major role in keeping an eye on foreign affairs of the country. With his straightforward and outspoken views, Sri Subramanyam Swamy is known for his courage and dare-do. He is an academician, economist, and politician in the true sense. We are honored to welcome Dr. Subramanyam Swamy.
Dr. Subramanyam Swamy, we would like to honor you as the most influential politician in India. Could you please join us on stage and accept this award? We request you to kindly speak a few words to the audience, sir.
Honourable Governor, distinguished former Chief Minister Sri Yedurappa, Meena Das Narayan, Hebron Mr. Koshi, I am most grateful for this honour. And when we strive without worry about what we will get or what we will lose, it's these honors which keep your spirits up. This country was once upon a time the most developed country in the world. Due to certain misfortune, the decline took place about 1,000 years ago and continued till 1947. perhaps we could have recovered quickly after 47, but we adopted the wrong economic model. And this was rectified in the 1990s for the first time when a government was formed which was not from the Nehru family. And therefore, the process continued. Today is actually the day when Narasimha Rao passed away. In the morning, I addressed a memorial meeting for him. And I was also held a cabinet rank position in his government and saw how the economic reforms was pushed and implemented by him. He has died unsung, but that's not going to be for very long. And I hope that one day, very soon, he'll be recognized for what he did to this country. But in one blow, he disproved what people were using as propaganda against India, that India can't grow beyond 3.5% per year, which was maliciously called the Hindu rate of growth. He transformed that rate of growth to 8% within 5 years. And since then, 8% seems easily attainable. I think we can now proceed on to a much higher growth rate. But India doesn't lack resources. India is full of potential. It can raise resources by a number of means. If instead of giving away the spectrum, we had auctioned it, we would have got that amount which is equal to the revenue we get from income tax. If today the Supreme Court having cancelled the coal allocation blocks, we now proceed to auction it, then one auction will give you 5.5 times what you pay as revenue for the government in the form of income tax. So there is no shortage of resources in India. There is enormous potential. We are the only country in the world which can do or carry out agricultural activities for 12 months of the year. United States and Europe, 5 months of the year, there is snow. So they cannot do agriculture in those 5 months. And therefore, India can, without additional technology or investment, grow 3 crops a year. But we don't. We grow only in 25% of the land, more than one crop. If we triple the crop, there will be plenty in this country, not only to feed ourselves, but the whole world. We have 150 million cows, but they give only 200 liters per year. One Israeli cow gives you 11,000 liters per year. And if 150 million cows start giving the Israeli average for milk, I'll probably have to come to Bangalore swimming in milk, that much milk will produce. So, you can go on and on. We have the youngest population in the world. The average age of India is today 26 years. The average age of China is 35. The average age of America is 37. Of Europe is 46. Of Japan is 50. This young population is capable of transforming this country through innovations. Just as the younger generation in the United States, by jet engines, by fax machines, and now by internet, has transformed the economies of those countries. Therefore, India is on the, what I would call as the precipice of a leap into great global status. And for that, we need a clean economy. We need a clean society. We need a new kind of an Indian who's ready to take risk and is not afraid of taking risk. To meet failure and then to rise again and fight again. That is all within our reach. And that is what makes me confident that India would be in the next 10 years amongst the world's developed countries of the world, and that's the place of India's destiny. I hope all of you and we will celebrate that occasion when you have the awards again 10 years from now. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Our next award winner is not only a scientist par excellence, but also a Carnatic vocalist and a Kathakali dancer too. Dr. K. Radhakrishnan, who made India proud by sending a satellite to Mars in the first attempt itself, is a soft-spoken person whose mission is to use the Indian space program to accelerate India's development process and thus benefit people. His focus is clearly on the technology development that India has been able to achieve in space research. Now let us watch a short clipping about Dr. K. Radhakrishnan.
And have achieved the near impossible.
Dr. Radhakrishnan, we would like to honor you as the most influential scientist in India. Could you please join us on stage and accept the award? Sir, we request you to kindly speak a few words to the audience.
Honorable Governor, distinguished former Chief Minister, the soul of the Gulf Connoisseur, Meena Das Narayan, Mr. Koshi, all distinguished invitees present here, all those distinguished persons who are being honored today, I am deeply touched by this gesture. It's a great privilege, and all this because I happen to be part of a great family, ISRO, of 16,000 plus people who are there and thousands of people who have been there for the last few decades, who all strive to fulfill the vision of a few great men of this country. And what we did was again for the people of this country, which gives us satisfaction. India today is in the league of the six space-faring nations, and for years we have been there. But what we showed on September 24th was we are the first country who did such a complex mission for the first time perfectly. We also showed to the country that on the technology front, we are there, and that's what we did on January 4th, January 5th, 2 days, where the cryogenic engineering stage was prepared for a launch, and we launched it. And just
A few days ago, we showed again we are in the game, doubling the capacity of India to launch communication satellites of 4-ton class, and we also paved way for a new dimension of human space flight. All this because of the synergy, because of the group effort and the dedicated, devoted, focused activity of a great team. Impossible become possible through this action. And I take this award on behalf of all those people who made this possible, past, present, and live for the posterity, an organization which is one of the best in the world. And I have a privilege to be part of that organization. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. We request you to kindly take your seat. Our next award winner is Chris Gopalakrishnan, who ironically was not meant to be a software engineer. His parents wanted him to be a doctor, but destiny took another turn, and he ended up becoming the CEO of Infosys. This soft-spoken person is a technophile with a fondness for mobile phones and laptops. Chris, who has received the Padma Bhushan, has also been involved in philanthropy. He donated $35 million to the Indian Institute of Science for Brain Research. Now, let us watch a short video about him.
The year 1955 was the year of birth of one of modern India's most distinguished computer professionals, Senapati Gopalakrishnan. Born to PG and Anandavalli Senapati on 5th April, he spent his childhood in Thiruvananthapuram. After completing his schooling at the Government Model School and a bachelor's degree in physics at the University College, he joined IIT Madras. His stint at IIT, where he went on to complete an MSc followed by M.Tech, turned him into a confident young man. It was in IIT Madras that he got his now famous nickname, Chris.
When I went to the computer center, you know, I had to give a user ID. Gopal was taken, Gopi was taken, Krishnan was taken, Krish was taken. So I was left with only Chris.
IIT opened the door for Chris's first job at Putney Computers. This is where he met NRN and other co-founders with whom he would go on to script an incredible success story.
I met Chris and a couple of other youngsters. So I had to choose amongst the three. And I gave a very tough exercise to all the three. At the appointed time, he came back to me. And I was stunned to see the quality of his work. I don't think I could have done as good a work as he had done at his age.
The year 1981 was the beginning of a new journey, both professional and personal. He not only joined hands with Narayana Murthy and five friends in co-founding Infosys, he also married Sudha.
I met him in 1980 in Bombay. First impression, he doesn't talk much. He's a man of very few words, and I'm the opposite. But somehow it clicked, and that's how our life started.
With his wife and family firmly behind him, Chris dedicated himself to building Infosys brick by brick along with the co-founders. Over the years, he served Infosys in various capacities, from head of technical support, customer services, and client delivery, to being the chief operating officer and president. In his various roles, Chris dedicated himself to building long-lasting relationships with several of our clients. Chris was appointed the CEO of Infosys. His exemplary leadership was recognized by leading publisher Institutional Investor when it voted Chris as the top CEO in the IT services category in 2011. Chris's impact as a leader and thinker went beyond Infosys. As a global business and technology thought leader, he has chaired numerous international forums like the World Economic Forum, the Indo-US CEO Council, and industry bodies like the CII. He is also on the board of governors of educational institutions like IIM Bangalore. His commitment to promoting entrepreneurship and young talent saw him establish the Startup Village in 2012, which has gone on to incubate more than 2,000 companies so far. Chris is a philanthropist with a vision. Apart from establishing the Pratiksha Trust, he donated 225 crore rupees to the Indian Institute of Science in Bangalore for establishing a brain research center. His seminal contributions to Indian industry were recognized by the Government of India in January 2011 when it awarded him the Padma Bhushan, the country's third highest civilian honor. Chris is admired the world over, not just for his business and technology acumen, but also for his humility.
Chris is a perfect gentleman. He has always put the interest of the company ahead of his personal interest. Not only that, he has even put the interest of his colleagues ahead of his own personal interest in every transaction.
As a friend, I think...
As he takes a step back to allow the next generation of leaders to carry the Infosys story forward, he has only one message for Infoseons.
I am very confident in telling every Infoseon that there is nothing that they cannot achieve through hard work, through their own commitment and value systems.
Mr. Chris Gopalakrishnan, we would like to honor you as the most influential Indian in the field of information technology in India. We request you to kindly say a few words to the audience, sir.
Honorable Governor of Karnataka, Sri Yediyurappa, former Chief Minister of Karnataka, Ms. Meena Das, Mr. Koshi, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, it's a privilege for me to receive this award tonight, along with many other people who are being recognized today. Every one of them a leader in their own field. I want to thank the Kanesa magazine for this recognition. And of course, this recognition would not have been possible without the success of Infosys, the dedication and commitment and hard work put in by more than 200,000 plus Infoseons past and present. As part of the journey in the last 33 years of course, creating Infosys, but also creating the IT industry in India, which today is responsible for 30 lakh, 3 million plus jobs, responsible for 6 to 7% of India's GDP, 25% of India's exports. It's an industry that's $120 billion. And an industry which has created more than 8 lakh jobs here in Bangalore. So it's a industry which has had significant impact in our country, in our state, in Bangalore. And I'm very proud to be here today and thankful for all the people who have made this happen. Thank you very much.
We request you to kindly take your seat. Our next award winner is a living musical maestro par excellence, Dr. L. Subramanian, who is not only an acclaimed world-famous violinist, but also a composer and conductor trained in the classical Carnatic music tradition and Western classical music. He is renowned for his virtuoso playing techniques and compositions in orchestral fusion. Dr. L. Subramanian is well known as the Paganini of Indian classical music and the god of Indian violin. He combines the serenity of an Indian musician and the magnetism of a Western star. Constantly moving from Singapore to Paris, from Delhi to Los Angeles, he has conquered every audience with the elegance and virtuosity of his style. Now, let us watch a short video about him. Dr. L. Subramanian, we would like to honor you as the most influential musician in India. Could you please join us on stage and accept the award? Audience, sir.
Honorable Governor, His Excellency, Honorable former Chief Minister of Karnataka, Sri Chirappa, Mrs. Veena Das Narayanji, Mr. Koshiji, and all my friends and colleagues, great achievers who are here. When I saw the earlier achievers, I thought I was in the wrong place. I think basically I'm a musician. I play violin. And what I heard from my previous recipients, I think I'm in the wrong place. But in any case, just to say a few things about my father. For everything in our field, in culture, the very most important thing is your guru and a guide. Without your guru and a guide, you can't get anywhere. My father was my guru, my mother was a great inspiration, both were musicians. My father, when he was playing the violin was treated as an accompanying instrument where, you know, in a concert, if you play more than the main artist, you lost your job. You didn't have any more concerts after that. It was a tug of war. So when in that circumstances, he decided to take the violin as a solo instrument and change the whole approach to violin. So we developed a lot of unbelievable techniques which doesn't exist in any part of the world. That made the change for our Indian violin to reach to all the continents. And whatever he taught me, I practiced and I did it. He's not here to receive the award. I receive this on his behalf. Thank you very much. I greatly appreciate it.
We request you to kindly take your seat. Our next award winner can feel the very pulse of the common man. Dr. N.K. Venkatramana is a renowned neurosurgeon well known in national and international circles. He has received microneurological training from Nordstadt Krankenhaus, Hanover, Germany. After a successful career as assistant professor in neurosurgery at NIMHANS, he started the Manipal Institute for Neurological Disorders in 1991 with complete neurosurgical facility. He participated in several clinical research programs and initiated neurosurgical teaching programs. He is instrumental in establishing the Advanced Neuroscience Institute at BGS Global Hospitals. He plays an active role in various scientific societies of the country in neurosurgery. Most prominently, he is the most humane doctor whose mission is to help the common man through facilities like ambulances in highways to help accident victims. Now, let us watch a short video about him.
Dr. N.K. Venkataramana is a highly accomplished and world-renowned neurosurgeon of our country. He is currently the director of Global Institute of Neurosciences and vice chairman of BGS Hospitals. Fondly known as Dr. N.K.V.R., he has performed over 15,000 successful surgeries in the past 28 years, giving rebirth to thousands of families, thus igniting kindle of hope to their life. He has many academic distinctions to his credit and has published hundreds of national and international scientific research articles and has authored chapters in textbooks. He is one of the pioneers in stem cell research related to the neural regeneration. He plays an active role in various national and international scientific societies. Dr. N.K.V.R. is a medical activist and thinker known for his exemplary oratory skills. He firmly believes in advocating public awareness regarding healthcare and has been successful in doing so through a variety of multimedia portals. Not only being an acumenous personality, he also has an impressive track record of distinctions throughout his career. He has been honored with prestigious Karnataka Rajyotsava Award, Dr. B.C. Roy Award and many more. He has established a very unique, noble, free ambulance service, CTC Sanjeevani, reaching out to the accident victims in the golden hour. This is one among the many of his important and unique charitable initiatives, rescuing lakhs of accident victims and saving lives. He has also introduced highway trauma care and air ambulance service in Karnataka. Recent, his golden initiative is to treat accident victims in golden hour beyond economic barriers. Dr. N.K.V.R., a multifaceted personality of enthusiasm and impetus of strength and pride for his team. They take this opportunity to appreciate and honor him for his creative and innovative thinking and his service-oriented mindfulness.
Dr. N.K. Venkataramana, we would like to honor you as the most influential medical icon in India. We request you to kindly say a few words to the audience, sir.
His Excellency, the Governor of Karnataka, former Chief Minister, Sri B.S. Yediyurappa, Mrs. Meena Das Narayan, Mr. Koshi, distinguished invitees, prestigious award winners, ladies and gentlemen, I am indeed honored for being chosen for this prestigious Gulf Connoisseur Award this evening. Equally, I am humbled to share this platform with some of the most pioneers and achievers of this country at the same time. And also feel pride and honor for receiving this award from none other than His Excellency, the Governor of Karnataka. When a country is full of natural resources, it is considered a wealthy country. On the other hand, where it's full of human resource is considered as a problem or a burden. Today, we are in this dilemma. As a neurosurgeon, we have two challenges in this country. One is to prevent the physical brain drain that is happening day in and day out. Every 6 minutes, there is an accident in this country. We are losing precious lives of the most productive young age group of this country every day. And on the other hand, we are pushing accident victims to become disabled for the rest of their life. Today, unfortunately, India has the reputation of having the highest number of deaths related to the accidents in the world. It is our responsibility to change this attitude. While we stand our own strength, it is necessary that we protect our rich resource, what we have. Brain is a crown jewel in creation, and any accident is going to make them disabled. Our Honorable Prime Minister has launched several programs to take this country forward, like Swachh Bharat, Make in India. It is necessary that we also consider Suraksha Bharat and Safe Bharat for ourselves. The other biggest challenge I do face in this country is how to preserve the valuable brains you have been seeing here and retain them active as irrespective of the age. We are doing considerable research on this front. We are almost at the point where we can regenerate the brains and repair the brains. And today, I am going to be the most proud Indian of this country. At BGS Global Hospitals, we have launched a golden initiative where people with accident victims with brain injury will be treated free of cost, irrespective of the economic barriers in the golden hour, through a trust called Dhanvantri Trust. The January 8th is going to be the World Ambulance Day. We are going to launch officially about the Save a Life concept in Bangalore. It is possible that we behave ourselves as a civic society, we can prevent these injuries. It's a man-made damage that's happening to the country. So, if 12 million Bangaloreans can join together and contribute 1 rupee per person per annum, believe me, I can treat every single accident victim of this Bangalore city beyond the economic barriers in the golden hour and save many more lives to come and preserve the rich resource what this country has and make many more achievements and be a role model for this world. Let's start and make Bangalore city a safe city and take this to the entire nation and teach the world that we can be a safe country. I once again congratulate Mrs. Meena Das Narayan for all the successful way forward she has taken it through the Gulf Coast this year, and also thank immensely for bestowing upon me this wonderful award. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. We request you to kindly be seated. Our next award winner is an artist who lets his beautiful artwork speak for him. Mr. B.K.S. Verma is an artist from Bangalore, India, who specializes in live painting in front of large audiences in a short span of time. In school, he enjoyed sketching his classmates rather than concentrating on the class itself. His interest was further fueled by artistically inclined parents. His mother Jayalakshmi, an artist herself, was his constant guide. He was strongly influenced by the legendary artist Raja Ravi Verma. In the process, he followed his style and adopted his surname as well. Now, let us watch a short video about him. Thank you. Verma, we would like to honor you as the most influential artist in India. Could you please join us on stage and accept the award, sir? Sir, we request you to kindly say a few words to the audience.
ವೇದಿಕೆ ಮೇಲೆ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಎಲ್ಲ ಗಣ್ಯರಿಗೂ ಸಭಾ ಸಹೃದಯ ಕಲಾಬಂಧುಗಳಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಕಲೆ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದಾಗೆ ಬರೆಯೋದು ಚಾರ್ಟ್, ಅನುಭವಿಸಿ ಬರೆಯೋದೇ ಆರ್ಟ್. ಬದುಕು ಸಂತೋಷವನ್ನು ಹಂಚಿಕೊಳ್ಳೋದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ತುಂಬಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಇಂಥ ಸಂತೋಷ ಕೂಟದಲ್ಲಿ ನನಗೆ ಅರಿವಿಲ್ಲದೆ ಬಂದ ಈ ಪ್ರಶಸ್ತಿ ನನಗೆ ಖಂಡಿತ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ನಮ್ಮ ತಾಯಿಯವರು ಮಾತಾಡೋರು, ಶ್ರದ್ಧೆಯಿಂದ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡು, ಕೆಲಸ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದ್ದರೆ ಜನ ಹುಡುಕೊಂಡ್ಬರ್ತಾರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದರೆ ನೀನೇ ಹುಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನನಗೆ ಬಂದ ಪ್ರಶಸ್ತಿಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಕೂಡ ನಾನು ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೂ ಹಾಕಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದಾಗದೇ ಬಂದಿರೋದು. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಹೇಳಬೇಕು ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ, ನಾನು ಆರ್ಟಿಸ್ಟು, ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಆರ್ಟಿಸ್ಟ್ಗೆ. ನೋಡುವ ಹೃದಯ, ನೋಡುವ ಕಣ್ಣು, ಅನುಭವಿಸೋ ಹೃದಯ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆಯೋ ಅಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲೂ ಸಂತೋಷವಿರುತ್ತಂತೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಮಾತು ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ನಾವು ಕವಿಗಳು, ನೀವು ಕಿವಿಗಳು. ಹೇಳುವ ಕವಿ ಕೇಳುವ ಕಿವಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಹೇಳುವ ಕವಿ ಏನು ಕೆಲಸ ಅಂತ. ಪ್ರೇಕ್ಷಕರು ಅನುಭವಿಸಿದಾಗ ಕೂಡ ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಸಂತೋಷವೇ ಕಲಾವಿದರಿಗೆ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ತುಂಬಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಈ ಸಂತೋಷದಲ್ಲಿ ಮೀನಾದಾಸ್ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ ವಂದನೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ವೇದಿಕೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಕೃತಜ್ಞತೆ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ. ನಾವು ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ.
ಬಹಳ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು ಸರ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್. ವಿ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಟು ಕೈಂಡ್ಲಿ ಬಿ ಸೀಟೆಡ್. Our next award winner is a very dynamic sports icon from Manipur who has made India proud in the field of boxing. She is a national champion and a former world champion in the lightweight class. In 2009, she was awarded the Arjuna Award by the Government of India for her achievements. What is admirable about this young lady is that she put her career at risk when she took the courageous decision to return her medal, for she knew she had fought and fought well. We all saw the scenes on TV and knew this was no ordinary woman, for her opponent seemed to receive all the punches, and we knew a star was born. While we will not dwell on the decisions made by the sports jury, we know for a fact that Sarita Devi will take Indian boxing to great heights. Now let us watch a short video about her.
Through to the women's lightweight semi-final in the red corner from India, Vaishnavi Devi. And please, ladies and gentlemen, your appreciation from Wales.
Mrs. Sarita Devi, we would like to honour you as the most influential sportswoman in India. Could you please join us on stage and accept the award? We request you to kindly say a few words, madam.
Respected governor, may last 14 years in India team se khel rahe ho. After शादी के बाद बहुत टफ है बॉक्सिंग में आना, तो लड़की के लिए कोई भी काम शादी के बाद कंटिन्यूस करना है तो हस्बैंड का सपोर्ट बहुत ज़रूरी होते हैं. तो मेरा हस्बैंड हमेशा सपोर्ट करते हैं और मेरा कोच उधर बैठा है, दोनों ने मुझे बहुत सपोर्ट किया. उसकी वजह से आज जो मैडम मीना मैडम मुझे अवार्ड दे रहे हैं, उसकी वजह ये लोग के वजह से मुझे ये अवार्ड मिला है. फिर एक और बड़ा चैलेंज आ गया, अब तक बेबी होने के बाद, बच्चे होने के बाद दोबारा बॉक्सिंग आना और ज़्यादा टफ हो रहे थे. तो उसके साथ साथ मेरा हस्बैंड बहुत सपोर्ट किया, उसकी वजह से मैं दोबारा एक बच्चे, अभी मेरा एक बेटा है 1 साल 9 मंथ्स का है. तो मैं उसके बाद फिर कंटिन्यूसली मैंने 1 साल से पहले मेरा बेबी जो हुआ 1 साल से पहले छोड़ के मैंने ये कंटिन्यूसली मैं बॉक्सिंग में दोबारा आया, कमल गेम्स में मेडल मिला, एशियन गेम्स में गोल नहीं मिल नहीं पाया। मैं अभी कंटिन्यूसली बॉक्सिंग कर रही हूँ। मैं अपना देश का एक बार ओलंपिक में गोल लाना चाहती हूँ, तो सभी मेरे लिए प्रयास कीजिए, मैं ओलंपिक में एक बार गोल लाकर अपना देश का नाम रोशन कर सकूँ। धन्यवाद मैडम, थैंक यू सो मच मैडम, जो आपने जो अवार्ड देकर मुझे बहुत बड़ा मोटिवेशन दिया है और मुझे बहुत बड़ा इंकरेज किया है। थैंक यू सो मच मैम। थैंक यू,
बहुत शुक्रिया सरिता जी। टेक योर सीट। आवर नेक्स्ट अवार्ड विनर इज वी रविचंद्रन, द सुपरस्टार ऑफ कन्नड़ा मूवीज। His flair for technical perfection has made him produce several movies that have gone on to be super hits. He wears a million hats. He's an actor, director, music director, lyricist and editor, and is often considered as the showman of Kannada cinema. His role as a mentally challenged adult in Ramachari was featured at the Ontario Film Festival. He is known to be a non-conformist. When he's not shooting, he can be found editing, creating music or writing scripts. He has taken life's ups and downs with equanimity and emerged a winner. His contribution to Kannada films is immense. Now, let us watch a visual from his forthcoming movie, Apurva.
Seconds. Mistakes happen in seconds too. Obstacles happen in seconds. Opposition happens in seconds too. 1 second can start a life and a life.
Ravichandran, we would like to honor you as the most influential movie star in India. We request you to kindly say a few words to the audience, sir.
Respected elders, friends, ladies and gentlemen, I am really surprised at this award. I really don't know how I should this category here. But the only thing I can say is I bow my head to this award and to all the awardees here. This makes me very happy, not just because I received the award, it is because I was a part of this awardees and I met them. This award makes my day wonderful, makes my life beautiful, and makes my future very responsible. Thanks to Gulf Connoisseur and Minadar. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. We request you to kindly be seated. Now may I request His Excellency Shri Vajubhai Wala, Honorable Governor of Karnataka, to kindly address the audience.
कर्नाटक के पूर्व मुख्यमंत्री आदरणीय श्री येदियुरप्पा जी, आदरणीय श्री मीना जी, आदरणीय श्री कोशी जी, अत्र उपस्थित सब सज्जनों, देवियों और मीडिया के मित्रों, सबसे पहले तो जो एक मैगजीन छपने वाले ने अपने राष्ट्र के ताकतवान लोगों का सम्मान किया, इसीलिए पहले तो ये मैगजीन को मैं बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देता हूँ। और जिन्होंने अवॉर्ड प्राप्त किया है वो सभी को मैं मेरी ओर से और कर्नाटक की प्रजा की ओर से बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देता हूँ। मित्रों, आज जिन्होंने अवॉर्ड प्राप्त किया वो सब लोग अपने देश के वो एसेट्स है। एक एक आदमी को देखेंगे तो अपन को यहाँ बैठे हुए में सब कॉमन लगेगा, मगर उसकी इंटेलिजेंसी और उसकी कुशलता वो अपने राष्ट्र के लिए बहुत जरूरी है। एक एक क्षेत्र में कहेंगे ये अपन सब लोगों को ये प्रेरणा देने वाला आज का प्रसंग है। हम कहेंगे कि यदि आदमी के पास कितनी भी एफिशिएंसी हो, कितनी भी इंटेलिजेंसी हो, मगर जो उसको यदि अपॉर्चुनिटी नहीं मिली ने तो वो एफिशिएंसी कोई काम में नहीं आती। और एफिशिएंसी को अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलने के बाद भी उसमें करेज और हिम्मत होना चाहिए। जो हिम्मत नहीं होती तो तुम्हारी एफिशिएंसी और अपॉर्चुनिटी उसका कोई काम नहीं है। मैं तारीफ नहीं करता, मगर यहां हम स्वामी जी को देखेंगे, वो पॉलिटिक्स में कोई भी बात हो, किसे कितना भी बड़ा आदमी हो, मगर उसका कार्य राष्ट्र के विरोध की बात है तो हम उसके सामने झंझावत से लड़ेंगे। परिणाम चाहे कोई भी आए, मगर हम हिम्मत से उसका सामना करेंगे। वो हिम्मत भी राष्ट्र के लिए अच्छे काम के लिए करते हैं। मित्रों, आपके पास कितना भी ज्ञान हो, मगर जो आपके में हिम्मत नहीं है ना, तो वो ज्ञान का कोई उपयोग नहीं कर सकते। इस देश में पोटेंशियलिटी काफी है, मगर ये पोटेंशियलिटी को जिस तरह के अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलना चाहिए, उसको जितना साथ सहकार मिलना चाहिए वो आज तक नहीं मिला, ऐसा मैं नहीं बोलता, मगर कम मिला है वो बात सही है। आज देश में 65% युवा पीढ़ी है, युवकों है, और 65% में आज हम देखेंगे कि उसमें जो एफिशिएंसी और इंटेलिजेंसी है वो बहुत ज्यादा है। हम देखेंगे अब जो हम पढ़ते थे और जो परीक्षा में हम जितने मार्क्स लाते थे उससे हमारा बेटा ज्यादा मार्क लाता है, और उससे भी इसका जो पुत्र है वो उससे भी ज्यादा मार्क लाता है। अपन के समय में हमने कभी देखा नहीं कि 100 में से 98 और 99 मार्क्स आ सकता है। हम पढ़ते थे तब तो 3 साल का मार्क एकत्र करने तो भी 99 होता था, मगर आज डे बाय डे इनके इंटेलिजेंसी, उसके इंटेलिजेंसी को उसको सपोर्ट देना, और उसको जिस तरह से आदमी को भूख लगती है इसी तरह इंटेलिजेंसी को भी प्रोत्साहन देना बहुत जरूरी है। और ये हम देखेंगे यहाँ जिन लोगों ने जो अवॉर्ड प्राप्त किया वो कोई अभिमान से नहीं। इसरो का चेयरमैन ने जो यहां आकर कहा कि ये अवॉर्ड ये मेरा नहीं है, मेरे साथ कार्य करने वाले सभी कर्मचारी का ये फल है। हम कहेंगे कि यहां पहले भी हमारे ऋषि मुनि थे, उसके पास कोई साधन नहीं था, मगर वो कहते थे कि मंगल में भी जीवात्मा है। जब इसरो से मैं भी था, आजम जो चेयरमैन भी था, और इंडिया के प्राइम मिनिस्टर भी वही इसरो पे हाजिर था, जब मंगल यान में जो उसकी ऑर्बिट में जो यान ने प्रवेश किया, तब जो हमको आनंद मिला, हमको नहीं सारा हिंदुस्तान को आनंद मिला कि दुनिया में पहले प्रयत्न से ही हम मंगल की ऑर्बिट में प्रयत्न कर सकते, वर्ल्ड के अच्छे अच्छे साइंटिस्ट भी न कर सका वो इसरो वाला ने करके बताया। मैं तारीफ नहीं करता, मैं कहता हूं कि ये पोटेंशियलिटी है, इस देश में इंटेलिजेंसी भी है, और इंटेलिजेंसी को अच्छी तरह से उसको अपन को प्रोत्साहित करना चाहिए। हम ये किसी की तारीफ करने के लिए बात नहीं है, मगर देश के प्राइम मिनिस्टर ने कहा है ना, मेक इन इंडिया, हमारे ये हिंदुस्तान में सब बनाओ। हिंदुस्तान में कोई दुनिया पर ऐसी कोई चीज अशक्य नहीं है कि हम नहीं कर पाते। हम जानते हैं कि बिल ग्रेट वो सारे वर्ल्ड में धनवान आदमी है, क्योंकि उसके पास इंटेलिजेंसी ज्यादा है। मगर मैं कहूंगा कई सालों, थोड़ी सालों के बाद, कई नहीं थोड़ी सालों के बाद इस देश में इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी वाले में बिल गेट से भी ज्यादा इंटेलिजेंट अपने देश में आएगा, क्योंकि घर की मुर्गी दाल बराबर कदीम होती है, हम उसको नहीं जानते हैं। बस वो ये क्या है, या सुब्रमण्य है ना, वो तो मेरे साथ पढ़ता था, मेरे साथ खेलता था। अरे तेरे साथ पढ़ा और कहीं निकला, वो इंटेलिजेंट हो गया, तू तो वो ही रह गया। ये इसको अपॉर्चुनिटी देना चाहिए और हिम्मत से भी कहना चाहिए। यदि हम बोलते हैं ना, विल देर इज अ वे। स्वामी विवेकानंद शिकागो की धर्म सभा में गए थे ने, तो उन्होंने कहा था कि मैं जाने वाला हूं, मैं जाकर ही रहूंगा। उन्होंने प्रयत्न किया। जो आदमी सारे वर्ल्ड में धर्म सभा में अच्छे बोलने वाले आदमी, वो अगली रात ये म्युनिसिपालिटी के डब्बे में बैठकर ठंडी से कांप रहे थे, ऐसे स्वामी विवेकानंद जी का उसका हिम्मत देखिए, करेज देखिए। और जब वो शिकागो की धर्म सभा में गए और अपने देश की नामना पहले ही शब्द में कहा, माय ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर, फॉरेन वाले ने कभी ब्रदर और सिस्टर का आदर भाव से नाम लेना वो सुना नहीं था, पहले ही वाक्य में सब लोग तालियां लगाने लगे। ये आत्मीयता का भाव है। हमारे देश में पैसे कम है, इंटेलिजेंसी ज्यादा है। जो आदमी यदि कोई प्रमाणिक होता है, तो प्रमाणिक आदमी हमेशा प्रगति करता है, वो दुनिया में कभी दुखी नहीं होता। चाणक्य ने भी नीति सूत्र में कहा है, सुखस्य मूलम धर्म, सुख का मूल धर्म है। धर्म यानी आरती करना, पूजा करना, ये गीता का पाठ पढ़ना, ये नहीं। धर्म का अर्थ है कि तुम प्रमाणिकता से जीवन व्यतीत करो। जो आदमी प्रमाणिकता से जीवन व्यतीत करता है ने, वो कभी किसी से डरता नहीं, वो अमर हो जाता है, वो कभी मरता नहीं। जो डरता नहीं वो कभी मरता नहीं। देश में ये हिम्मतवान लोगों की हमको जरूरत है, जो बुरी बात आए उसके सामना करने के लिए हम आगे आना चाहिए। चाहे अपना भाई हो तो भी उसको बुरा किया है, उसको सजा होनी चाहिए। इस बक्कमता वाला देश हम आगे प्रगति करेंगे वो हम देख सकते हैं। और आज जब सब किसी की तारीफ नहीं करता, मगर आज सब लोग कहेंगे कि हिंदुस्तान में कई राजकारणी लोग आए, और आज जो देश का जो बड़ा प्रधान है तो वो क्या करता है, उसी में हिम्मत ही है ना। जो हिम्मत से काम लेते हैं और कॉन्फिडेंस है कि मैं ये करके ही रहूंगा, जो आदमी में कॉन्फिडेंस है ना, वही प्रगति कर सकते हैं। और ऐसे कॉन्फिडेंस वाले लोगों ने, ये मैगजीन ने जो सबका सम्मान किया, राजकारणी का सम्मान किया, उन्होंने स्पेस वाले का सम्मान किया, इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी वाला का सम्मान किया, मेडिकल लाइन वाले का भी उन्होंने सम्मान किया, संगीतकारों का भी सम्मान किया, स्पोर्ट्समैनों का भी सम्मान किया। हमारे यहाँ काफी प्रकार की इंटेलिजेंसी पड़ी हुई है, उसको अच्छी तरह से प्रोत्साहित देना वो हमारा कर्तव्य है। आज देश में दो टाइप के लोग हैं। एक ऐसे लोग हैं कि वो अपनी जात को अच्छा दिखाने के लिए कोशिश करते हैं, सर पे अच्छा क्रीम लगाना, फेशियल वेशियल अच्छी तरह से करना, सूट अच्छा पहनना, टाई अच्छी पहनना, और जो हमारा सूट है, बूट है, वो अच्छी तरह से लेना, वो अच्छा दिखा। जो आदमी अच्छा दिखाने के लिए कोशिश करता है वो कभी अच्छा नहीं हो पाएगा। आदमी को अच्छा होने की कोशिश करने की जरूरत है। मैं लेडीज के बारे में बात नहीं करूंगा। जिससे कोई नहीं, आईब्रो कराने से कुछ मिलता है, फेशियल कराने से कुछ मिलता है, अच्छे होने की कोशिश करो। जो आदमी एक दफे निश्चित कर ले के मैं ये करूंगा, एक दफे जो आदमी निश्चय करेगा तो अशक्य को भी शक्य कर सकता है। हम कहते हैं ना कि जो आदमी पुरुषार्थ होता है ना, वो पुरुषार्थ वो अपना प्रारब्ध भी बदल सकता है। गीता में भी कहा है, पुरुषार्थ करना मगर अपेक्षा मत रखना, कर्मण्यवादी का रस्ते महाफलेशु कदाचन। व्यक्ति तो काम किए जा, फल की आशा रख नहीं। मैंने भाषण दिया और मैं सुबह में पेपर खोलूंगा और जो पेपर में मेरा फोटो नहीं आया, कुछ नहीं आया, तो मैं निराश हो जाऊंगा। अरे तूने भाषण दिया, उसके अलावा तेरी बीबी भी नहीं तेरी मानती, तो दुनिया वाले क्यों मानेगा? ऐसे तेरे में कौन सा अच्छाई का गुण है? भाषण से आदमी कभी नहीं करता, कर्म ही अपना धर्म है। इस देश में कर्म करने वाले की पूजा होती है, भाषण करने वाले की कभी कोई वो नहीं करते। वो तो बोलते ये तो भाषण करके चला जाएगा, कोई काम नहीं करता। जो आदमी काम नहीं करता वो कभी रिजल्ट ओरिएंटेड नहीं होता। आइए हम सब मिलकर अपने देश के एक एक आदमी की ताकत है और एक एक युवाओं की ताकत है, वो युवाओं की ताकत को हमको अच्छी तरह से बढ़ाना चाहिए। भूलो मत, अपने अपने कवियों ने भी कहा है कि युवाओं को प्रोत्साहन दो और युवाओं के लिए कोई काम अशक्य है ही नहीं। युवाओं की प्रशंसा करते हुए कवियों ने भी कहा है, युवान क्या चीज है? तो कवियों ने कहा है कि जो चट्टानों से टकराए, जो चट्टानों से टकराए उसे तूफान कहते हैं, और जो तूफानों से टकराए उसे युवान कहते हैं। इस देश में युवाओं में काफी ताकत है। हमको नहीं समझता, सब हमको आता है, ये तो कल का लड़का है। ये कल का लड़का नहीं है, वो हमारे भविष्य के लिए राष्ट्र की एसेट से युवाओं को अच्छी तरह से प्रोत्साहन देना चाहिए। आइए हम सब साथ में मिलकर अपने देश में जो एफिशिएंट लोग है, वो एफिशिएंट लोग जिस तरह से आज जिसका सम्मान किया है, वो एफिशिएंसी लोग, हम उसको भी विनंती करेंगे कि हमारे देश में यही संस्कृति में रहा है कि एक दीप से जले दूसरा। जो डॉक्टर अच्छा हुआ तो वो डॉक्टर ज्ञान जो जाता है तो अपने साथ ले जाने की जरूरत नहीं है, वो कई लोगों को तैयार करने की जरूरत है। एक्सपर्ट लोगों है, जो संगीतकार अच्छा होगा तो उसको चार युवान और चार युवती को ढूंढ लेना, उसको बोलना बेटा बेटी मैं तुझे सिखाऊंगा अच्छी तरह से, तो कॉन्सेंट्रेशन करके देख लो। जो स्पेस की बात करने वाला है तो वो कहेंगे कि आइए मैं तुझे ये क्या है विज्ञान मैं तुझे सिखाऊंगा। इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी वाले, ये बेंगलोर तो क्या है, ये सारे वर्ल्ड में जो बेंगलोर आज दूसरा नंबर है, वो दूसरा नंबर भी 5 से 7 साल में मैं देखता हूं कि वर्ल्ड का पहला नंबर ये सब आएगा। इतनी ताकत है। आइए, विशेष तो नहीं कहूंगा, हम सब साथ में मिलकर अपने देश में जो एफिशिएंसी वाले लोग हैं उसको ज्यादा से ज्यादा उसको प्रोत्साहित करें, उनको अच्छी तरह से अपॉर्चुनिटी दे, और हम सब साथ में मिलकर जो प्राइम मिनिस्टर ने आज कहा है मेक इन इंडिया, तो हम हमारे इंडिया में सब वस्तु बनाकर इंडिया को भी ऐसा बनेगा कि सारे वर्ल्ड में उसका नाम रोशन हो। इसी वाक्य के साथ मैं आयोजकों को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देता हूँ, और जिन्होंने अवार्ड प्राप्त किया उसी को भी परम कृपालु परमात्मा बहुत शक्ति दे, ऐसे आशीर्वाद के साथ मैं मेरा वक्तव्य पूर्ण करता हूँ। धन्यवाद, आभार। भारत माता की। अरे यार, जिला पहुंचा जय बोलते हैं, अपनी माता की जय बोलना तो वो ऊपर से बल्ब गिर कर नीचे आना चाहिए। जो जिसमें हिम्मत नहीं है, जो ताकत से कोई आदमी स्लोगन भी नहीं बोल सकता, वो काम क्या कर सकेगा? मातृभूमि के लिए तो अच्छा जोरदार से बोलना चाहिए। कोई भी परिस्थिति में आए तो यदि मातृभूमि को याद करेंगे ना तो सब तुम्हारी समस्या दूर हो जाएंगी। मैं फिर से बोलाता हूँ, अच्छी तरह से अच्छा आवाज निकाल कर और दिल से बोलिए अपनी माता की जय। भारत माता की धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू वेरी मच सर। आई नाउ रिक्वेस्ट श्री बी एस येडियुरप्पा, फॉर्मर चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ कर्नाटका, टू काइंडली एड्रेस द ऑडियंस।
डिग्निटीज, द डायस, ऑनरेबल गवर्नर ऑफ कर्नाटका श्री वजूभाई जी वाला जी, माय वेल विशर, ग्रेट एडवाइजर, करेजियस स्टेट्समैन एंड बीजेपी लीडर श्री सुब्रमण्य स्वामी जी, टुडेज सेंटर ऑफ अट्रैक्शन ऑल द अवार्डीज ऑफ दिस ब्यूटिफुल इवनिंग, प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ बीसीके श्रीमती ललिता दास जी, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, आई एम रियली हॉनर्ड टू बी हियर अमंग यू ऑल फॉर अवॉर्डिंग मोस्ट इन्फ्लुएंशियल इंडियंस organized by this elite forum. I am delighted that after a long time, Karnataka is blessed with ideal governor who had charmed Gujarat Assembly with his humble personality and carries record of presenting 18 budgets as Finance Minister of Gujarat. Friends, in 2014, India was important player in the world due to various reasons, and I am sure it will be so for next few decades. It is playing positive role as a force of stability, peace and prosperity. Be it successful Mangalayana Nobel Prize awardee Dr. Kailashi Satyarthi or appointing श्री विवेक मूर्ति एस सर्जन जनरल ऑफ यूएसए फॉर ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर एमर्जिंग एज सेकेंड मोस्ट पॉपुलर लीडर इन द वर्ल्ड और टू बी एट रीसेंट विनिंग ऑफ कबड्डी वर्ल्ड कप, होप यू ऑल अग्री विथ मी दैट वी आर सर्टेनली फीलिंग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड प्राउड। इफ आवर कंट्री इज ए कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ्स दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द कंट्रीज पार्शियली हैव or don't have, like talent, unity and diversity, world-class excellence in these areas of information technology, medicine, research, sports, arts, etc. If India is highly capable and hugely respected by rest of the world, it is mainly because of our influential personalities like you who are being awarded here. I thank the sponsor of this program for making this 2014 a meaningful one by inviting me as guest of honor to this wonderful program. I hope they continue to do this great job of sponsoring these meaningful events in the coming years too. This award indeed inspires awardees to perform better in their chosen careers. With this hope and trust, I wish you all a Merry Christmas and a very happy and prosperous New Year 2015. Thank you once again.
Thank you very much, sir. We now request His Excellency the Governor of Karnataka and Shri B.S. Yediyurappa to cut the ceremonial cake that denotes our 11th anniversary. We request Mr. Satish Koshi, Mrs. Meena Narayan, Mr. Priyanan and Mr. Narayan Nedungadi to join us. We take this moment to thank Chef Avjeet Ghosh, corporate chef, and his team for today's cuisine, including this beautiful cake. Thank you so much, sir. I request all the awardees to kindly come back to the dais for a photograph.
Collect your gift bags as you leave.
Thank you so much for being with us, and do continue to enjoy the wonderful saxophonist, the saxophone maestro, Mr. S. Raman, as you have written him. Thank you.